local seafood association is suing the federal government to try to stop new rules that small business owners say will put them out of business. They involve a guest worker program and a double-digit wage increase. WDSU News reporter Rosa Flores has been following the developments and has another story you'll see only on 6. Good morning, Rosa.
Randy, good morning. Now, this affects a lot of shrimp, crab, crawfish, and alligator processors who use H-2B visa workers to operate. Now, this is a federal program that allows employers to request guest workers from other countries when workers are not available for work right here in the United States. Now, Louisiana is 5th in the country when it comes to the request for these visas. Louisiana requests more than 2,200 workers. Now, according to the Department of Labor, the rules would create an H-2B visa registration process. It would allow employers to conduct labor market tests and increase the amount of time U.S. workers are recruited for these jobs. But small businesses say that there is also another rule, a wage bump of 50% to 83% for all guest workers, and this would go into effect on September 30th. Now, we've learned about one seafood processor who says that he's paying $8.07 an hour right now. Well, those wages would increase to $14.77 an hour. And if he does that, the increase has to apply to everyone at his plant. If these changes are implemented, business owners say they'll go out of business. Take a listen.
Crawfish, alligator, all these are seasonal items that we bring these individuals in that are good, hardworking people that enjoy their jobs and make money and help the economy out, because these are legal, you know, workers that pay their tax, anybody else. So the seasonal part of it is very important.
Now, Harlan Pierce Arcel says that Louisiana would lose about 85% of production because business owners can't afford this wage increase. Now, I also talked to a representative of the National Guest Worker Alliance Program. It's an organization that was created right here in New Orleans after Hurricane Katrina, when guest workers were brought in to rebuild the city. Here's what he says. He says, quote, "By raising wages, the Department of Labor is responding to the many complaints by these workers and to the job crisis in this country. Now, if workers in America are not taking these jobs, it's because of the job conditions." On your side in the newsroom, I'm Rosa Flores for WDSU News. Randy, back to you.
And is that the reason why, Rosa, that they're having to hire from out of the country, because they're not getting the demand here in the States?
You know, it's a very interesting dynamic. I've heard several processors explain it to me this way. After Hurricane Katrina, there was an outflux of people from this area, and they say that a lot of these folks never came back. And so they're having to reach outside of the United States to bring in guest workers. So it's a very interesting dynamic, because they're trying to stay in business and they need seasonal workers. So it's, you know, in the summertime, it'll be crabbing. And so they need these workers in for a certain period of time. And so they're really fighting this because they really, really want to keep these guest workers, because otherwise they don't have hands to do the work.
All right. All right. Rosa Flores for us. Thank you for that report. And, you know, 50 Congress members, they're behind that effort right now to stop the implementation of the wage increase to guest workers. And Rosa, it will show us the letter and what that says in about 30.